Hello and welcome class 7 students. Today in this class we are going to solve some more sums based on formula chapter exercise 12. Yes, today also we will continue with exercise 12. Now in exercise 12 we have learned this formula initially. This formula we have learned, and we have learned also the applicability of these two formulas also. Now we have learned a few videos before that how to express as a perfect square. Suppose a number is given like 25a square plus 30abc plus 9b square c square. Suppose this sum is given to you and you are asked to express this as a perfect square. This means the derivation is given to you. You have to express the square of two terms, the square of summation of two terms. That means you have to bring the first line through back calculation. You have to express this line. This line is given to you. This line is similar to the derivation, and you have to bring back that the line, that is the initial line, that is the, you have to show that this is the square of two terms. You have to express this as the sum of two terms, the square of sum of two terms. That means derivation is given, you have to bring back this position, that is the square of sum of two terms, you have to show it. Now 25a square, we know it is the square of 5a whole square plus 2abc. That means if this is a, this is the first term, then we will write 2 into the first term. And second term we don't know. So before writing the second term, we will write this 9bc square, b square c square. So 9b square c square means 3bc whole square. So 3bc whole square is the second term. So 2 into a into b. Here we will write the second term again, that is 3bc in this sum. Now we can match this line with this line. If this is similar, then you are doing the sum correctly. That means 2 into 5, that is 10 into 3, 30abc. So this is equal to this. That means you are doing the sum rightly. Now this whole sum is the square of first term and second term. This whole line is the square of, as if this line is the square of a plus b whole square. In the same way, this line is the square of first term and second term, that is 5a plus 3bc. Definitely this line is the whole square of 5a plus 3bc. So this is the perfect square expressed as required. So this line will be given to you and you will be asked to express as a perfect square. Express as a perfect square. If you are asked to do that, you will solve the sums in this way and express the given sum in perfect square as the sum or the subtraction of the perfect square as given. If plus is given, it will be sum of the perfect square. If minus is given, it will be the subtraction of the two terms and the square of it. Now, after this, the sum doesn't end over here. Suppose you are given the numerical value of these algebraic variables. Suppose in the sum, it is given that the numerical value of these algebraic variables, that is the value of A is given in the sum as 2, the value of B is given in the sum as minus 1, and the value of C is given in the sum as 1. These three things are given to you in the sum. And you are asked to place this numerical value in the algebraic expression and find the full value, find the numerical value of this 5a plus 3bc whole square. How will you solve the sum? You will write 5 into a, that is here a is 2, so 5 into 2 plus 3 into b into c, that is 3 into b means minus 1 and c means 1 whole square. Here, 5 into 2 means 10 and plus 3 into minus 1 into 1 means minus 3. So, 10 minus 3 whole square, 10 minus 3 whole square, which means 7 whole square, and 7 whole square means 49. 7 whole square means 49. So, 49 is the answer in the sum. 49 is the answer. 7 whole square, that is 49. That is 49. I write 49 over here for your convenience. 7, 10 minus 3 is 7, and that is 7 whole square is equal to 49 is the numerical value in this sum. Very quickly, I am doing another sum so that you can understand how to solve the sums. Suppose another sum is given to you. 25p square plus 90pq plus 81q square. So, 25p square is the square of 5p. 5p whole square plus 2 into 5p into, here second term is 81q square, which is 9q whole square, which is the square of 9q. So, we will write 9q in place of the second term. So, 2 into 5 is 10. 10 into 9 is 90pq. 90pq is given in the first line, which is equal to this 2 into 5p into 9q. So, we are doing the sum rightly. Now, further we will do the sum. That means this line is the square of 5p plus 9q. 5p plus 9q whole square. Now, suppose you are given the value of p and q. The value of p is given minus 2. And the value of q is given as 1. So, what you will write? 5 into p. P means minus 2. The numerical value of p is minus 2. So, we will write over here minus 2 plus 9 into q. Here q means 1. So, 9 into 1 whole square. Now, this becomes minus 10 plus 9 whole square. Minus 10 plus 9 whole square. Now, minus 10 plus 9 becomes minus 1. So, finally it is becoming minus 1 whole square. And minus 1 whole square is 1. Ultimately, answer is becoming 1. In this way, you have to express this as a perfect square and find the numerical value as given in some of the sums of exercise 12. Practice these sums hard. These sums are very easy. So, practice it number of times so that you can get easily with the sums. You can get the sums very quickly. So, in my next class, I am going to show you more sums based on this formula of exercise 12. Till then, goodbye.